Welcome to this session of my video series. We shall discuss the use of arrays or matrices in C and C++. The word matrix is rarely used for an array in common programming parlance. So I will stick to the word array. An array is a wall-to-wall arrangement of elements. Two adjacent elements share a common wall. This is an array of houses because there is a common wall between adjacent ones. There are two basic conditions for an arrangement to be called an array. Firstly, the walls must be shared. Secondly, the items must be of the same type. Biscuits in a packet of biscuits is an array because all items are biscuits. Houses in a street are an array because all items are houses. This code will help you understand the whole point. Here I have created 9 int variables. You can see how difficult is it to use so many commas and to find so many names for our variables. It becomes very difficult to find more and more names. It becomes more and more difficult to keep track of these names as the code grows. You can imagine the problem if you need a very large number of variables. Things will become difficult to manage. This code declares an array of 20 int types. The compiler guarantees that they will be laid side by side. This is the type name for the array. In this case, it is an int. This whole thing is called the declarator. This is called the array identifier. This can be any positive constant integral expression. It gives the number of elements contained inside the array. You can see that it is very easy to create a large number of items in bulk. There is just one identifier for all the items. The first item has index 0. The second item has index 1. The items of an array are numbered from 0. This is technically called zero-based indexing. This code shows how to access the first item of the array. Notice the use of an index number in the brackets. It is very convenient to access the items. I told you in the beginning that array items must lie side by side. This ensures that the compiler can easily locate and access them. The compiler needs to know the address of the first one and it can locate any other by adding the index number to the staring address. This is the real reason that makes arrays a very convenient and fast structure. The size of an array has to be known at design time. Design time is the time when the code is being written by a developer. This has to be a constant expression. It has to be hard-coded by the developer. This is a compiler error. The size of the array must be a constant expression. It cannot be specified by taking user input. This is also a compiler error because x is a non-constant. This code compiles fine because x is a constant. The compiler knows that x will stay a constant till the end. So it has reasons to trust the contents of this variable. Array's elements can be given values with the help of initialization. In this code, an array is being initialized with an initializer list. This is called a braced initializer list. Seven goes to the item at index 0. 88 to index 1. And 3 to the item at index 2. If the number of items in the initializer list is less than the size of the array, then the remaining items are given default values. Only two initializers have been specified. The size of the array is 4. So the last two values will be set to 0. This is the output of the program. The last two integers are initialized to 0. The default value of char is null. Of a float and double is also 0. An initializer list cannot have more initializers than the array size. It is a compiler error because the size of the array is 3. And the number of initializers is more. In this code, the size of the array has not been given. The compiler can determine the size from the initializer list. This is called automatic initialization. The array size is automatically determined from the initializer list. An array is a side-by-side arrangement of items. All the items must be of the same type. The array size must be defined at design time. We also learned about the various methods of initialization. Thank you.